Oh, 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 Merry Christmas!
Hey guys, welcome to the 100 sub special video, just as I promised. This is my Christmas present for all of you. If you're already a subscriber, I'm glad to see you again. If this is your first time here and you like what you see, be sure to join the crew by hitting that nice red subscribe button. I'll talk about the future plans for my game, but first, let's just jump back in time to see the major changes that I've implemented since the start of the year. One thing you should know is that I started working on this project around 2020 November. And I just want to mention that this game had an ASCII prototype, but that's the topic of a future video. So let's see what do we have here. There will be goofy looking parts as well, so be prepared for a laugh. When I first recorded some game footage, it was all about just showing it to my friend. That time the game already had a working menu, a basic fight system with loot, and an awful looking shop. Now the game includes the following features: main menu, hero choice, story, fight, skills, inventory, shop, dialogues, etc. If you want to hear more about the structure, I recommend the first devlog video right here. So let's see the comparison. All the old footages date back to 2020 December. Here's the main menu. I didn't find any video about me browsing it, but it's the same as what you've probably seen in my second devlog video, except the new logo and the new fonts. You can see that there was a lot of things here that got improved, well, mostly the UI. Back then, upon starting the game, we've been greeted with a fight. Sorry, just a sec. Hey, what's up?
Hey kiddo, this is not the fight.
What do you mean this is not the fight?
This is the CCS.
Don't tell me that I left it out, I have to edit the whole part again when the video is completed.
I bet you, sweet mama.
Oh my god, can you come and help?
My pleasure.
Thank you. Seems like I screwed up, but I get some help. Be right back.
Hello there. Let me handle this quick. In the older version, there was a developer option to turn off the CCS, aka character selection screen. When making this video, we made a mistake and only used footages where it wasn't included. So we apologize. Let us use this short clip from our last video.
Then I wanted to let the players create their own heroes. I defined 6 races, 4 classes, and 2 genders. We could switch between these settings and see the stats changing with them below. Sorry about this guys, let us continue the video. This is basically a casual turn-based combat where you can select which enemy you want to hit. The graphics was really simple. This was my first time trying out pixel art. I didn't know about framerate independency back then, this stuff helps your game run much smoother with a constant speed. You can see that all the movement here is kinda jaggy. Let me know if you want to know more about this delta time slash framerate independency stuff, it's worth a short tutorial. Since then, the overall proportions of the screen kind of stayed the same, but I've implemented better sprites, background image, basic animation, potions, skills, also my game became framerate independent, and the UI is much cleaner. I already had a loot screen 1 year ago, and I didn't improve it really much. I've added a background image and a cool experience bar with changing load speed. Also, you can see and hear some cool acceleration in the coin number 2, that's about it. One last screen that was included in the older version is the shop. The first try for this screen was like caveman simple. I didn't even care that the text was half off screen. You could spend your gold that you got from the fights and upgrade any of your sets for some money. Okay, but let me introduce probably the funniest state of this screen. Long ago in my ASCII game there were 3 plus 1 shops and I wanted to include the same amount of merchants here too. So I made a so-called market screen where you could choose between these shopkeeps and meet them. And I could just include these modifications in the video because I've made them on December 31, literally on the last day of 2020. I was traveling with my mom and I was drawing these images on my laptop sitting on the backseat using paint with touchpad. Well, have a look! Amazing, right? So you could see 3 random weapons in the first row and the selected one below with more information. What? You see no information. Yeah, of course, let's see my desperate tries to make it look good. So first I added some kind of background. Then you could see your current weapon on the left side and the selected one on the right side. Well, still looks like shit. Oh yeah, and I've also added some bonuses to the weapons. If an equipment has some kind of rarity, it has a different color from white. One final thing was that I replaced these ugly images with some kind of decent ones. And what changed in the shop since then? Well, see for yourself. I won't tell details about it, because this will be the topic of a future devlog video. And what about the other screens? Well, the new screens, as I mentioned, include the story, the character, the inventory, and the dialogue. That's about all the upgrades. Now let's see what the future holds. You can expect some devlog videos about all of the remaining screens. I'll probably develop the characters in the near future, also work on the story screen and the story itself. I want to talk about the statistics of the characters and how they build up too. It's probably a more distant upgrade, but I'll rework the battle system a little bit while clearing up the code, because it's a mess, believe me. I'll put some effort in the character screen, also redo the skill tree and the inventory. Last but not least, I'll try to focus on making better animations. And that's it for my future plans concerning the game. As you can see, there's a lot to do, but I'll try my best to live up to your and my expectations. Now that I have a great audience, I want you to be proud of me and I want to motivate all of you. And yeah, I also got a suggestion that I could include some codes in my videos to help and inspire you even further. My answer to this is thank you. I will try to help anyone to improve in Python and PyGame, so I'll make some easy RPG tutorials too in the near future. So that's about it. Let me know in the comments section how you like the video and the overall improvements. If you enjoyed it, be sure to leave a like and subscribe. Let's make 2021 amazing together. I wish all of you a Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays. Have a wonderful time with your loved ones, your family and your friends. See you next year. But until then, stay safe and take care.